King, help the spirit of truth, for our present and ever, fulfilling all things. Treasure your blessings and source of life. Come and abide and cleanse false stain and save our souls with good. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to men who enjoy the Savior. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to men who enjoy the Savior. O Lord, open my lips and my mouth and speak out this praise. Blessed is the kingdom, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of all the churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy church and for those who live with faith, piety, and fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our most blessed archbishop, the then, the venerable priests, the deacons in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the president of our country and for all the protection and military service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy place, for all the surrounding towns and countryside, for the faithful dwelling in it, and for the entire nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our favor, with an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
travelers on land and on sea and in the air, for the sick, the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all danger, affliction, anger, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the birth giver of God,
and ever
give us. Let us offer ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God. For to you are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Oh, Thank you.
Mercy on us.
us be attentive. Peace be unto all.
Unto your spirit.
Wisdom.
The prohemen on in the seventh fold. The righteous one shall rejoice in the Lord and shall set his hope on him.
The righteous one shall rejoice in the Lord and shall set his hope on him.
Hear my voice, O God, when I pray unto thee.
The righteous one shall rejoice in the Lord and shall set his hope on him.
Children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs.
Let us listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be unto all. The readings are from the Holy Gospels according to St. Matthew and St. John.
For their health and for their salvation.
Господи,
помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, forgiveness and remission of sins of the servants of God, especially for the Archbishop Greek Roman, the Archbishop Greek Patrick, the Archpriest Andrew, Nan, the Octave Fee, Matushka Barber, Presbyteria Janice, Jerome, Dionysi, Thomas, Suhail, Diane, Elizabeth, Nancy, Clement, Elizabeth, Christian, Bessie, Bereskiva, Daria, Maria, Mary, Betty, and Daniel, and for all the members, founders, and benefactors of this holy place.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings to this holy and all venerable church, for those who do good works, for those who serve, and those who sing, for all the people who are present, awaiting your great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O Lord our God, accept this humble supplication from your servants, and have mercy on us according to the multitude of mercies. Send down your compassion on us and all your people, awaiting from you great and rich mercy. You are merciful, O God, the lover of mankind, and we offer glory to you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Catechumens, pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord have mercy on them.
Lord, have mercy.
That he teach the word of truth to them.
Lord, have mercy.
That he reveal the gospel of righteousness to them.
Lord, have mercy.
Be united to this holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Lord, have mercy.
Save them and mercy on them, help them and keep them, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Catechumens, bow your hands to the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
So that these together which may glorify our laudable, magnificent name, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. All catechumens depart, let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again, in peace, pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
We ask you, for to you are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Lord,
again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, that being always guarded by your might, we offer glory to you, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Oh,
Our God.
To thee, O Lord.
accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call on you with their whole heart. Also accept the prayer of sinners and bear it to your holy altar. Enable us to offer your gifts and spiritual sacrifices to you for our sins and for the sinful errors of the people. God is worthy of divine grace before you, that our sacrifice be pleasing to you in the grace of your Spirit. May rest on us and on these gifts you have set forth, and on all your people. Through the compassion of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Proclaiming,
holy, 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 Lord.
You are holy, all holy, you and your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit. You are holy, all holy, in your glorious magnificence. You loved your world so much that you even gave your only begotten Son, so that he who believes in him will not perish but will have everlasting life. In the coming and fulfilling all his mission on our behalf, in the night in which he was sold, more clearly in which he gave himself up for the life of the world, taking bread with his holy, pure, and blameless hands, giving thanks, blessing, sanctifying, and breaking, gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins. And likewise, after supper, he took the cup, saying, Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Therefore, remembering this commandment of salvation and all those things done for us, the cross, the grave, the third day resurrection, the ascension to heaven, the enthronement at the right hand, the second and glorious coming, we offer you your own, in behalf of all and for all. For those who live pure and honorable lives, Grant peace for government to all civil authorities, O Lord, so that we and their colonists may lead religious and reverent lives in peace and in quiet. First of all, remember, O Lord, our most blessed Archbishop Nathaniel, and preserve him for your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, to teach rightly the word of your truth.
Remember all your people.
Remember, O Lord, this holy place, all cities, towns, and villages, for the faithful dwelling in them, and for the entire nation. Remember, O Lord, travelers on water and land and in the air, the sick, the suffering, captives in their salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who bring offerings and do good in your holy churches, and those who remember the poor, send down your mercies on all of us. And grant us to glorify and praise, with one mouth and one heart, your honorable magnificent name, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
And may the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you. Having remembered all the saints, again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, lover of mankind, has accepted them on his holy, heavenly, and spiritual offer, as a spiritual fragrant offer, will send down on this divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Having delivered from all danger, affliction, anger, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day be perfect, holy, peace, and not sin, let us ask of the Lord. God, the guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. All which has been useful for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we make of the remaining time of our lives in peace and penitence, let us ask of the Lord. Judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us offer ourselves and one another in our whole life unto Christ our God. We entrust our whole life and hope to you, O Master and Lover of mankind. We ask and pray and humbly prostrate before you, not as worthy to partake with your conscience of your heavenly and awesome mysteries of this holy and spiritual table, for remission of sins, for forgiveness of transgressions, for communion of the Holy Spirit, for inheritance of the heavenly kingdom, for confidence toward you, but not for judgment or for condemnation. And make us worthy, O Master, and with confidence without fear of condemnation, we boldly call you the God of heaven, Father, and say, thank you.
Thank you. truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first. And I believe also that it is true that I know most of your body, and that it is true that I am precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in all of your ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thine obscure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mysteries to thy enemies, neither like Judas who have laid me a kiss, nor like a thief, for I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, and thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment, nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body.
With fear of God, and in faith and love, draw you near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord.
Oh,
forever and unto ages of ages. Let us be attentive, having partaken of the divine, whole, pure, immortal, heavenly, enlightened, giving mysteries of God. Let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, and bless us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Passing the whole dignity, perfect, holy, peaceful, without sin, let us offer ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God. We thank you, Master, lover of mankind, benefactor of our souls, that this day you have counted us worthy of your heavenly and immortal mysteries. Straighten our way, strengthen us all in fearing you, watch over our lives. Steady our footsteps through the intercessions, the prayers and intercessions of the glorious birth giver of God, and ever Virgin Mary, and of all your faults. For you are sanctification, and we offer glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord. Guard the fullness of your church, sanctify those who love the beauty of your house, glorify them by your divine power, and not abandon us and put our hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your church, to the clergy, to the civil authorities, to all your people. For all that is good, everything is perfect, is given us from above, coming down from you, the Father of all lights. We offer glory, thanks, and worship to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Thank you. whose memory we celebrate today, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for he is good and the lover of mankind. Amen. In the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Something for you here, light coffee hour. Lunch today will be at 1 o'clock back in the dining room. And it's been 2 months. I had to give directions how to get into the house, how to get out of the house, but I think it's getting a little easier. You can walk on the blacktop, but you can't drive on it. So tomorrow I think we can start taking the rope down so people can drive on it. So anyway, glory to God. Keep praying for us. We are definitely climbing that mountain. We've been doing that all summer, with having construction going on at our front door, but it's getting done. I want to ask your prayers for a nun that most of you know, probably about, if not know her personally, Mother Dionymphe, who runs the food bank in Cleveland and St. Mary of Egypt Monastery, well-known serving the poor in the Orthodox Archdiocese. She's terminally ill, was stricken with a lot of illness in her life, but most recently a terminal cancer, and they did do a surgery yesterday. I don't know the results of that, but it's a risky surgery, we were told, but trying to do that to give her a couple of more months so that she could get everything in order, because she runs that pretty much single-handedly, her mission there in Cleveland. So pray for her and the board of directors and the mission and so on, and God work through everyone for his will to be done. Tonight, of course, our vigil is at 6 o'clock for those of you staying for the whole week. Thank you, Father. This one shall be. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. I thank thee, O Lord my God, for thou hast not rejected me a sinner, but hast made me worthy to be a partaker of thy holy things. I thank thee, for thou hast permitted me the unworthy to commune of thy most pure and heavenly gifts. But, O Master, who loves mankind, who for our sakes did die and rise again, and gave us these awesome and life-creating mysteries for the good and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Let them be for the healing of soul and body, the recovering of every adversary, the illumining of the eyes of my heart, the peace of my spiritual powers, of faith unashamed, the love unfeigned, the fulfilling of wisdom, the observing of thy commandments, receiving of thy divine grace, and the attaining of thy kingdom. Preserved by them in thy holiness, may I always remember thy grace, and live not for myself alone, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor. May I pass from this life in the hope of eternal life, and so attain to everlasting rest, where the voice of those who feast is unceasing, and the gladness of those who behold the unspeakable beauty of thy countenance is